The MKS 6000 upgrade kit includes RA and deck motor extension cables, MKS 6000 board and electronics box, Ethernet and XT60 pass-through cables with RA rear cover, and a new instrument panel. The tools you are using today are 2 14-inch or longer zip ties, an SAE Allen set, electrical tape, a knife, a 5/32 pro-hold tip driver, and a 5/32 T-handle wrench. Remove any payload or accessories installed on the mount before continuing forward with the installation. With the mount upright and in balance mode with the RA lock pin engaged, begin disassembly, starting with the deck worm block cover. Using a 5/32 Allen wrench, remove the 5 screws holding the cover to the worm block. Crack loose the 4 screws holding the worm block to the gear cover using a 5/32 T-handle wrench, then removing them with a pro-hold tip driver to stop the screws from potentially falling into the mount. If you do not have a pro-hold tip, place a piece of electrical tape on your standard Allen key and it should suffice. With the screws out, lower the worm block just enough to disconnect the homing sensor cable and then the motor extension cable. Remove the deck hole cover using a 5/32 wrench. Cut a length of electrical tape to wrap around the RA gear and cover to hold the mount upright while you remove the RA worm block. Removing the RA worm block cover is the same as deck removing 5 screws to get access to the worm block itself. Same as before, crack loose the 4 screws holding the worm block to the gear cover, then use a pro-hold tip driver to remove the screws completely. Carefully remove the homing sensor cable and motor extension cable before taking the worm block out completely. From here, move to the instrument panel. 2 screws underneath the panel can be removed using a 5/32 wrench. Pull the instrument panel away from the VersaPlate, remove the loom, and disconnect the through-mount cables starting with USB, then the white connector, black connector, and finally the ribbon cable. With the instrument panel off, remove the 6 screws holding the VersaPlate with a 3/16 Allen key. Using a 5/64 wrench, remove the RA rear cover. The electronics box is removed by 2 screws using a 1/16 Allen wrench. With the box lowered, carefully disconnect all cables, including the through-mount power cable, which is screwed into the electronics box. Remove the through mount cables. Pull the power harness down and through the deck hole by rotating the deck axis to access the different slots in the shaft housing the cables. You can use the round holes in the shaft to guide the connectors around to behind the deck shaft. With the through-mount power harness out, the USB cable should be a similar and easier process. Make note on how these cables are routed for reinstallation of the new 6000 through-mount cables. Remove the deck and RA motor extension cables. This will conclude disassembly. Beginning reassembly, start with the Ethernet and XT60 power cables, with the latter being pre-soldered to the RA rear cover. Tape a zip tie to one end of each cable so they can't slip out and feed it through RA to deck. Use the same routing that the USB and through-mount harness followed for the 5000 system, with the power going to the right and connection going to the left of the deck shaft. Once both cables are passed through the deck hole, route each cable on opposite vertical slots of the deck shaft and out the top of the gear. Routing the motor extension cables are next. For RA, tape a zip tie to the black connector of the cable the same way that the through mount cables were done, and route it through the upper hole of the RA tube to the rearmost hole of the RA base. This can be tricky, so have patience and take your time. Prepare the deck motor extension cable the same way and route it from the upper deck hole to the lower hole. After that, it can be routed around the deck shaft following the Ethernet cable and out to the RA rear. From there, push it through the RA base to join the other extension cable. Tuck in the through-mount cables. Start by pulling out all the slack from the RA rear cover so it can be reinstalled. Use the deck hole cover for excess cable. The new instrument panel can be connected, starting with the XT60, then Ethernet, then the harness loom. Using the loops of cable out of the deck hole, pull the instrument panel up to the deck gear and reinstall both the VersaPlate and instrument panel. Reinstall the RA worm block. Connect the motor to its extension cable and tuck it away. Bring the worm block close to the gear cover and route the homing sensor through the block and connect it to the sensor on the gear cover, making sure not to pinch any wires when securing the worm block. Be sure to start with the pro-hold tip so the screws don't fall into the mount. Torque with the T-handle and reinstall the RA worm block cover. Engage the lock pin at this time and remove the electrical tape securing the axis in place. Tuck the two loops of cable from the deck hole down below inside the deck tube and make sure the axis spins free of any internal cable snags. Reinstall the deck worm block exactly like RA, once again making sure not to lose a screw into the mount. Torque with the T-handle and reinstall the worm block cover. With all cables secured in the mount, you can reinstall the deck hole cover. Lastly, install the new MKS 6000 by connecting the homing sensor cable and both motor extension cables. The RA connector should have a silver dot to direct where it should be installed. Once everything is plugged in, consider powering on and testing your mount before attaching the electronics box to the mount.